This is Dr. Anina Abraham from Advanced Retina Care. I'm a retina specialist. I'm going to talk about how diabetes affects the eye. The common problems we see in diabetic patients are cataract, diabetic retinopathy, and glaucoma. Diabetic retinopathy is one of the most serious complications, and it happens due to prolonged diabetes. Even if your blood sugar is under control, you may still be having some amount of diabetic retinopathy. So it is extremely important for every diabetic patient to get his retina checked up. You will not even know about it till the last stages of the disease. Cataract is encountered in many patients. It comes much earlier in diabetic patients. It's a simple thing. It can be easily operated and taken out. And glaucoma, yes, we see it more commonly in diabetic patients. This is also treatable to a certain extent. Whatever it is, the retina checkup is absolutely mandatory in diabetic patients. Now, I want to talk a little bit in detail about diabetic retinopathy and how this progresses and how it affects vision. There are different stages of diabetic retinopathy. One is the background diabetic retinopathy. We call it non-proliferative diabetic retinopathy. In this stage, there are small bleeding spots all over the retina. There are small areas called microaneurysms which leak fluid and sometimes cholesterol onto the retina. So what happens is, with time, you can develop something called macular edema. Macular edema is nothing but swelling in the macula. The macula is the central portion of the retina, which is responsible for visual acuity, for fine visual acuity. So when this is swollen, vision starts dropping. That's when the patient realizes, yes, he has a problem with his eyes. He cannot see things as clearly as he used to see. Diabetic macular edema is a treatable condition. We need to give you some injections in the eye. We need to probably do some laser treatment to the areas which are leaking, but it should not be neglected, because what happens is, with time, it becomes chronic and it does not respond to any form of treatment. There are conditions like that. Even after treatment, they just don't respond. What do we do for these cases? We can actually operate them and make them respond to the drugs which we are injecting. Now, the next stage of diabetic retinopathy is proliferative diabetic retinopathy. Here, blood vessels start growing abnormally all over the retina. These are extensions of the normal blood vessels. They are not normal. They are very fragile in structure, and they can break at any time, causing bleeds within the retina. So if you start seeing red spots in your vision, you start seeing red floaters all over your vision, and sometimes you can even see a red patch coming down your eye, and suddenly your vision is gone. This is what some patients describe. It is a bleeding which has happened inside the eye. Why has it bled? Because of these fragile blood vessels. We call it neovascularization. That's why this condition is called proliferative diabetic retinopathy, because there is proliferation of new blood vessels over the retina. How is this treated? We can give injections to shrink these blood vessels, and we can do laser treatment all over the retina to preserve blood flow to the healthy portion of the retina. So laser treatment is a must in diabetic retinopathy when it has reached this stage. The last stage of diabetic retinopathy is tractional retinal detachment. Now, in this stage, fibrous membranes have formed all over the retina and they start pulling up the retina. And this causes a detachment. Your visual acuity drops. It could be in one field, it could be all over. Complete blindness. Now, once it reaches a stage of tractional retinal detachment, the only treatment option is surgery. You need to go inside and cut off all those membranes which are pulling up the retina and settle the retina with oil or gas. And that is the only way this is going to heal. If you neglect it with treatments like Ayurvedic therapy, it is not possible for your vision to come back. The earlier the treatment, the better the response. You get operated early, your vision can be preserved. Diabetic retinopathy is a condition which we can prevent by controlling the blood sugar, yes, but also getting regular retina checkups done. At one stage, a simple treatment is all you need. But if you neglect it, it may go into such a complicated stage that you may need surgery. And some cases, even after surgery, they just do not respond because the retina is so bad. Let us not wait till that stage comes. Let us get treated early, let us get diagnosed early enough. Now, it is also important to understand that diabetic retinopathy has a correlation with nephrology, that is, with kidney disease. If you have diabetic retinopathy, you need to also check up your kidneys, because diabetic nephropathy goes hand in hand with diabetic retinopathy. Now, the kidney starts leaking protein. This is an indication of severity of the disease. And once the kidney starts losing proteins, your macular edema also can increase and can become recurrent even after treatment. So it is important to balance it out. You need to treat the kidney as well. You need to control your cholesterol levels as well, and not just the blood sugar, not just the blood pressure. Now, I have seen most often patients with diabetes and hypertension have a much worse form of retinopathy. So it is extremely important to control both these conditions. Now, glaucoma is preventable. Preventable in the sense you can prevent worsening of glaucoma by using simple eye drops. Now, eye drops are meant to control the pressure inside the eye. And if you control the pressure well, you do not require surgery, you do not require any further treatment. Glaucoma is something in which the peripheral field of vision starts coming down. So the patient really does not even know that he has glaucoma until the very last stage, when only a tunnel vision is left. He is able to see only this much. So again, an early diagnosis, an early treatment will prevent progression of the disease to a very, very late stage. These are all the conditions associated with diabetes.